Welcome back to the English language learning class. Today we are going to discuss about notice writing. What is notice? So here it is. A notice is a medium to convey a message to mass together to a group, large group at the same time. Okay, so notices are written to convey some information, make a formal announcement about some event, etc. It should be simple and very lucid in style. Notices are either posted on the notice board or in a newspaper. Either posted on a notice board or given in a newspaper. So notice is a medium, we can say. Together it conveys its message to a large number of audience at the same time. It can be posted on the notice board, it can be given in a newspaper, but remember, the notice should be simple and lucid in style. After this, I'm going to show you the format of the notice. So this is the format of the notice, what I have given you, how to write, where to underline, what to do. Now first thing, remember, whatever you write, write it in a box. Make a box and then you write. Now format of notice, when I am saying format of notice, means name of the issuing authority, school or organization. That comes under your format of notice. You have to underline that. Next comes, you have to write notice block letters. Notice block letters, this also needs to be underlined. Okay. This also needs to be underlined. Then date. What is the format of writing date? You see, you are not allowed to write 5.11.2020. You are not allowed to write in that. You need to write 5th November, put a comma, 20XX. You are not allowed to write 2020. 20XX. This comes under date. Then your title or heading. This also needs to be underlined. Okay. Title. Heading. This also needs to be underlined. Then comes the main body of the notice, or we can say the content of the notice. As usual, you are giving an information, a notice. So you need to write the event, date, timings, what and when, where is your venue, and if any chief guest is there to be invited, you need to write chief guest. And after this, you need to put your name and designation. If no name is given in the question, you need to write your XYZ. You are not supposed to write your own name there. Unless and until you are told that you are so and so and write. If you are not getting any name in the question, in that case you need to write your XYZ. Now after this, you just have a look over this. Remember children, make a box. Format of the notice, underline this, name of the issuing authority. Notice has to be in the block letters, need to be underlined. Date format is 5th November, comma, 20XX. Don't forget to write. Format of notice is to be underlined, as I have already told. Issuing authority, this thing has to be underlined. Title or heading, underlined. Main body of notice or content, that means content, that is your event. What event you are giving? On which date it is going to happen, what are the timings for your things or the event, then where you are going, what, when, how, everything. You have to need it to be written and in a point wise. After that, if any chief guest is to be there, that also need to mention. And if you are given any name in your question, write that name and designation. Suppose it is given, you are Pallavi, you are the chief secretary of so and so club. So I need to write your Pallavi, chief secretary. If you have not given any name, you just write X, Y, Z. Over, everything is in a box. Just have a look over it, then I will be giving you the marks distribution. So this is your distribution of the marks regarding the notice. The first is your format, that contains your name of the institution, notice, title, date, writer's name with designation. Entire thing carries only one mark, that is important. Second comes content, what, when, where, who, how, where, when, what is the timing, what is the venue, everything, that contains two marks. And third one is your expression, that is what writings depends upon your fluency and the accuracy, that carries one mark. Okay, I have given you certain points to remember how to write your notice. The first one is, I have already told you, begin with the name of the issuing authority or the institution or the school or etc. use the word notice that I have done in block letters. You need to write in block followed by the name of the organization, and you need to underline as I have shown in the previous part. Write the date on the left hand side, and the format is 5th November, 20XX. You are not allowed to write 2020, that is wrong. Give a suitable heading to your notice, and it usually begins with, this is to inform or notify. It is hereby informed that this is a beginning of your notice. Remember, this is to inform or this is to notify that. It is hereby informed that. These are your beginning sentences. Next is your content. It should contain the purpose of the notice. Why have you given that notice? And you have to mention the details. That is your event. What is about? You are giving the notice. Your date, your timing, where you are going to organize those things. Your venue, your duration, how long it will take. Everything you need to mention in the content. Then in the 7th number, I have given the conclusion, that is conclude the notice with the name and designation. If any name or designation is not given, just write XYZ. Finish. Next, most important, make a box for the entire notice. Write inside a box. Okay. Last part is maintain your word limit. That is 50 words you have to follow. So first thing is, entire thing carries 4 marks. Marks distribution I have given. Your format, content, expression, 1, 2, 1. 4 marks. Over. Points to remember, begin with the name of the issuing authority or the organization or the school, anything. Second, write the word notice in capital letter, block letters, followed by your own name of the organization or the institution. Next, left hand side, you need to write your date, that is your format is 5th November, 2020. No, 5th November, 20XX. That is your format. If you are writing 2020, then it is wrong. Okay, maintain it 5th November. Today's date is 5th, so I am giving 5th November. You need not write that 5th November, any other date is given there. Okay, 5th November, 20XX. Then suitable heading. Then it usually begins. What is the beginning sentence? It is hereby informed that. This is to inform or this is to notify that. You have to begin your sentence. Then content should contain the purpose of the notice. Why have you given the notice? Well, you have to give the details of the events, where it is going to be organized, what is the time limit, duration, how long it will continue, when, how, where, what. That is your content. Then conclude the notice with the name and designation. If no name is there, you write XYZ. Then most important, make a box, whatever you have written in a notice, and your word limit should be 50 words. Maintain your word limit. So this is all about your notice. Just have a look. So this is all about your notice. I hope I have made myself very clear regarding your notice. You should not lose your 4 marks, at least marks count always. Okay, so go through your notice very clearly, and after this I'm going to upload another one video regarding your advanced writing skills. Till then, go through the videos, stay home, stay safe.